Welcome back. AC lesson number 7. What do you think? Shall we put some names to these lessons? Sure. Testing the AC system using pressure reading. Remember, there's two types of AC performance test. The first one we've gone over is easy. First, all you really need is a thermometer. Oh, that's right. You do need savvy knowledge. You need to look at certain things and touch certain things and measure certain temperature. You have to bring it all together. Just to make sure, you're going to visually inspect the clutch several times during the 3-minute operation. It's like your house. The clutch should stay on, the AC should stay on until it's nice and cool inside. That clutch has got no business turning off if it's not cool inside. You're going to be looking at the fans to make sure that they're working correctly. The cooling fans, and there's still plenty of mechanical fan clutches with the mechanical fan clutch. Yes, you already know how to touch the suction at the beginning and the end, and how cold should it feel? It should feel like ice water and condensate moisture. The thermometer goes in the center vent. Okay, you look, you touch, you measure, and you know the steps. Certain steps. All tests are done out of the sunlight. It makes a difference. The thermometer goes in a certain place, center vent. Crank it up, max cold, max AC, which usually puts us in recirculation. Know where your sweet spots are, because you're gonna touch them several times. Engine on, AC on, you idle for 2 minutes. While you're idling for 2 minutes, you're gonna pay attention to the clutch. You're gonna touch sweet spot number 1, sweet spot number 2, you're gonna look at the cooling fans, you're gonna look at the fan clutch. Steps continue. After 2 minutes of idle, you will then fast idle for 1 minute. You'll continue to look at the clutch, you'll continue to look at the fans because they can start doing different things. You're gonna start touching sweet spot number 1, sweet spot number 2. You'll take a measurement at the vent temperature, you'll return to idle and turn the engine off. What should the results be? Who remembers? Depends on 2 things. Thing number 1 is what type of vehicle you're working on. Each vehicle performs differently. Some vehicles are colder than others. The second thing is, where are you testing? Are you in Texas? Or are you in Colorado? Ambient temperature, that's what they call it, a fancy word for air temperature. Not only does it make a difference, it makes a hell of a difference. Here on the vent temperature, in the green, it's supposed to be around the 40s. That's what it says over here on the blue arrow. See the blue arrow? It says it's supposed to be 45 degrees coming out, but over on the yellow arrow, 65 degrees outside. We don't even need air conditioning. This is Colorado numbers. Down over here in the red arrow. Yes, there we are, South Texas, Corpus Christi. It's 100 degrees, 99, it's hot. Then temperature should only, at best, be 61. So yes, it makes a difference. Time for the new information. Now we're going to use pressure to test the AC system. There's 2 ways to measure pressure. One way is to use gauges. Another way is to use a station. Gauges and station. You'll get your hands on them real soon, no problem. The station. Let's go on. Low side, high side. We don't need the red. You're going to try to understand that it's best to stay away from the red. Keep coming to class and you'll understand. Now those numbers there, that's not for South Texas. Those are Colorado numbers. Remember, high side, low side, and I say screw the high side. It'll get you in trouble. We don't need that stuff. All you need is a low side. In fact, if you have, and so many do, domestic vehicles on the high side, they have this cost-effective crap that leaks almost every single time you connect to it. Do not connect to a service fitting that looks like that. Almost guaranteed is going to leak. Now, most of them are okay. Now, you should know you take a chance of creating a leak when you connect the gauges, but that's a risk that you have to take if the vehicle needs measurements. Okay, this kind of Schrader, they use forever. This is a good one. This one can be replaced and it doesn't cause a problem. All right, remember that piece of stuff on the left? Stay away from it. All right. You can do everything through the low side. What's everything? To safely measure the AC pressure, safe for you and safe for the vehicle. You're dealing with much lower pressure. You're not dealing with hundreds of pounds, and you're more likely not to cause a leak on the Schrader valve. This is where you add the Freon. It's called charge. This is where you take out the Freon. It's called recover. This is where you pull a vacuum. It's called evacuate. This is where you perform a leak test. This is where you add oil. It's called inject oil. This is where you measure low side running pressure. You measure static pressure with the engine off. You time equalization. What the heck is that? You're testing for restrictions. You'll learn more about that. You need any more? Sure, let's use it as a sweet spot. There they are, high side, low side. You do not need the high side. I'll tell you when you need the high side. Keep coming to class. There it is, the gauges. Let's start with the easy part, the color coding. You should know what blue and red is. The yellow hose, well, that goes several places. Right, it goes to your can of Freon, it goes to your vacuum pump, it goes to the recovery machine, it goes to the oil injector. The red is high side, the blue is low side. The hoses are color coded, the gauges are color coded, those knobs in the front are color coded. Same thing here, blue and red, whether it be on the hand wheels, the knobs, the gauges, the hoses, the quick connects, they're all color coded. Right, here we go. The next easy part, the hand wheels. In this particular manifold gauge set, the hand wheels are up front. There's two styles. Okay, what you should know about the hand wheels, they should be completely in the clockwise position. I'll go on. On these style, it's a little awkward to understand how they can look opposite, but they're really not anyway. Okay, let's get ready to connect. Now here's the tricky part. This guy here. This is a quick connect valve. Here it is here. Let's start with the easy part. This part, this is the collar. This is what you have to pull back. This is what you have to hold in the back position, just like you're gonna hook up an air hose to a power tool. That's easy enough. This is the hard one. This has to be in a certain position. In order to connect, in order to get the reading, this has to be in a certain position. And the words are sometimes not the best. Open and close. To connect, this needs to be backed off counterclockwise all the way. There's only one correct position, and it's backed off counterclockwise. This is correct. This is wrong. This is wrong. This is wrong. This is wrong. And it goes on and on and on. There's only one right place to put it, and that's all the way to the back. Wait till you get your hands on it real soon. Now they do have this other style. I'm sorry, that's not the one on the screen. They do have this one. I do not recommend this one. This one has the chuck and the collar, but it has no valve. These are troublesome because they leak. You know, like when you're trying to take a tire pressure measurement, you don't hold it just right and it hisses out the air. These do the same thing. So there's two types. With the valve that opens and closes, I call it manual, and this is the automatic. This is the one I highly recommend, but this one doesn't leak. This one leaks first thing out of the box. Let's go on. The red one's gonna have it too. The blue one's gonna have it, and those are those words. They're a little confusing. Step one is you pull the collar, just like you're gonna chuck up. You chuck, that means you connect, just like an air hose. And as soon as you chuck, you turn the quick connect valve to the open position. That means all the way, not halfway, not three quarters of the way, not most of the way, all the way. There's only two correct positions on this valve, all the way in and all the way out. So often students make the mistake of not turning the valve completely one way or completely the other way, and yes, it's going to affect the way you service the vehicle. Let's start with the engine off, AC off. It's called static pressure. There it is. What should static pressure be? What should static pressure be? Well, it depends. Here, if we look in the bottom, under fully charged, that means it's fully charged up with refrigerant, the ambient temperature is only 70 degrees. This is not Corpus Christi. This is Colorado. Texas is hot, remember? Hey, the readings are going to be different. I'm gonna slow down a little bit here because this is our very first, very, very important measurement. This measurement tells you how much freon's in the system. Here in South Texas, you should have almost 100. Anything in the 90s ambient temperature outside and with a little underhood heat, it should be 100. We'll get around to the red, right, when we have to, need to, but right here is our first measurement. It's supposed to be every bit of 90 to 100, and let's say it's only 57 psi. It's only 57, it's half empty. You already know that the system is low by measuring a static pressure. This is our first measurement. The next lesson will go on to start the engine, turn on the AC, and then watch to see what it happens. But at this point, if you don't have near 100 PSI static, engine off, AC off, the system is low. Now, if the needle is like at 110, that means somebody might have put too much freon in it. We'll have to go on a little bit more. Is this a good place to stop? I think so. Dun, dun.